guys, so today our topic of discussion is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So let's start out with the definition. So definition, COPD is characterized by irreversible obstruction to the airflow in the lungs. Irreversible obstruction, okay? Remember that point. Now coming to the aspect that COPD has two important disorders included in it. But I want you people to understand and to remember that it is not like one of them will just show and that is called as COPD. It's not like that. It is always that either chronic bronchitis will be predominant along with emphysema, or emphysema will be predominant along with chronic bronchitis. Okay, keep that in mind. So COPD includes two important disorders of the lungs which are pathologically distinct but clinically form a spectrum of single disease, and these disorders are chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Okay, now coming to the individual definitions, that is, emphysema is the hyperinflation or overdistension of alveoli with air. So clinically, hyperinflation of lungs due to obstruction of the airways. So here the alveoli will get overdistended, or it gets filled and it gets hyperinflated like a balloon. Okay, that is seen in emphysema. So now coming to the definition of chronic bronchitis. So chronic bronchitis is the chronic inflammation of the airways leading to increased bronchial secretion. Okay, remember that point, increased bronchial secretion and airway obstruction. So clinically this is seen as cough with expectoration or sputum on most of the days for at least 3 consecutive months. In a year for more than 2 consecutive years. So that person will be having cough with sputum for more than 2 consecutive years, and in a year he'll be having it continuously for at least 3 consecutive months. Okay guys, so now I am going to discuss about the clinical features. So first of all, I'll give you 5 important clinical features which you should remember, which is a must in exam point of view, and then I'll go into detail about all the other clinical features. So starting with the first one, that is, in emphysema, the people suffering with emphysema are called as pink puffers, and in chronic bronchitis, the people who are suffering from chronic bronchitis are called as blue bloaters. Okay, so in order to remember which name or which term is for which one, you just keep in mind that blue bloaters has the letter B and bronchitis also has the letter B. So blue bloaters comes under bronchitis. So obviously pink puffers comes under emphysema. Now I'll tell you why they are called so. So in emphysema, the person who is having emphysema will find it difficult to breathe, and that person will be taking rapid breaths. So he or she will exert, and that will cause a small difference in the color of the face. There will be a rose to pink tint on the face. That is why they are called as pink puffers. Now coming to the case of blue bloaters, they are called so because the person who is suffering from bronchitis will take in deep breaths, but there will be only a low amount of oxygen in the air which he or she is breathing. So obviously there will be symptoms of cyanosis. That is why the person is seen blue in color. Okay, so remember, this is the most important point, that is pink puffers and blue bloaters. Okay, predominantly emphysema with some degree of chronic bronchitis, then that person is called as pink puffer, and predominant features of bronchitis with emphysema, then he or she is called as blue bloaters. Now coming to the next important point, that is the age. Okay, age here you can see this person is little bit more old. Okay, so remember it like that, more than or equal to 60, around 60, then about 60, and here around 50s and above 50. So that is the second point. In emphysema, the dyspnea will be followed by cough, whereas in chronic bronchitis, Cough will be followed by dyspnea. So how to remember this? Chronic bronchitis, let us see, comes first. So remember it like that. In chronic bronchitis, cough comes before dyspnea. So in emphysema, dyspnea comes before what? Cough. And in chronic bronchitis, cough comes before dyspnea. Okay, remember, this is another important point. Now we have already discussed about the age, dyspnea, cough, and cyanotic symptoms. You know, cyanotic symptoms are present in what? Bronchitis, blue bloaters. About chest x-ray, hypoxemia, hypercapnia, then copulmonary and secondary polycythemia, I'll discuss later on, or you will understand it better after we discuss about the investigations and all the complications, everything. Extra stuff which you need to remember is the sputum is mucoid in what? Emphysema, and it is purulent in bronchitis. Okay, remember that point. And physical sign, there will be wheezing and chest will be noisy in what? Bronchitis. And infection also, it is more frequent in bronchitis. So all these are coming more in bronchitis. Remember it like that. Then it will be very easy. Along with what? Obstructive sleep apnea is seen associated with bronchitis. So this was all about clinical features. Don't worry, all the other points which I have boxed, that I'll discuss in the next slides along with investigation. So let's start with the investigation. So there are like a few common diagnostic features. So in order to find what the disease is, you have to start with the history. So history is common in both. But here in history, you have to remember, we talked about bronchitis, that is all that 2 consecutive years and 3 consecutive months and everything. You have to specify that in history. Coming to symptoms, cough and dyspnea is common in both, along with wheeze and hemoptysis. And signs, there is exertion during expiration, which happens in both. And when you do walking test, the person obviously will have difficulty in breathing. So that person will show disability. Okay, so the differential physical signs, in emphysema, there is barrel-shaped chest. So in order to remember that, I'll show you the x-ray, then it will get more clear for you. Then there is hyper-resonant percussion note in emphysema, which is all normal in what? Chronic bronchitis. But the next part, that is, there will be ronchi or the wheezing. In chronic bronchitis, the ronchi will be what? Coarse crepitations on both these sides. Okay, now coming to the next part, that is differential investigation. Okay, hemogram will show secondary polycythemia. It can happen in bronchitis too, but in your textbook, which I have followed for this video, in that textbook they're showing specifically in emphysema there will be secondary polycythemia evident in the hemogram. I hope all of you know what polycythemia means, or it is increase in the level of HP, okay, in your blood. Then the ECG will show a low voltage graph. So guys, here we have 2 x-rays. This is a normal x-ray on left hand side, and the one on right hand side shows your emphysema x-ray. So here you can see the chest is inflated, and the chest x-ray, there is no evident signs of the ribs or the blood vessels. It is all poorly defined, and the translucency has increased, or the blackness has increased. And here you can see the heart, its diameter transverse, in the transverse area, the diameter, you can see it looks decreased because the lung tissue has increased. So there is more radiosity. Actually, the heart size has not diminished. It's just that it is appearing diminished, and the diaphragm is more flattened. Okay, so you cannot appreciate it much in this posterior-anterior view. You have to see the lateral view to appreciate more that the diaphragm is flattened. So here you can see large air spaces and very evident indentations
which is seen, and you can see the lungs are barrel shaped, okay, in this emphysema. But in order to appreciate barrel shape also, you have to see the lateral view or the transverse view. So let's check the transverse view to see that. So all remember about this heart and everything, okay. So now coming to the transverse view, that is your posterior anterior view. This is the transverse view. Here you can see the barrel shaped chest and flattened diaphragm.
So guys, in the X-ray we saw all these points, that is increased translucency with large voluminous lungs, predominant bronchovascular markings in the hilum, then bullae formation, low flat diaphragm, then heart is tubular and centrally located. Okay, so next we are coming into the arterial blood analysis. So in both emphysema and chronic bronchitis, we have already told they're getting less amount of oxygen, so there will be hypoxemia and hypercapnia. So that is one point which you have to add in your what clinical signs, okay, which we talk are the salient features of clinical signs and symptoms. There you can add these two, hypoxemia and hypercapnia. And in chest X-ray you can add up the point about the shape of the chest. Okay, now coming to the pulmonary function tests. So FEV1 and FEV1 bar VC and PEF are reduced in both emphysema and chronic bronchitis. I'll tell you what FEV1 means. FEV1 is the forced expiratory volume in the first second, okay, and that ratio to the complete volume. So FEV1, FEV1 bar VC and PEF are reduced in both emphysema and chronic bronchitis. Now talking about the lung volume, the total lung capacity and the residual volume are increased in both emphysema. Okay. So now coming to the GOLD criteria for COPD severity. GOLD stands for Global Initiative for Obstructive Lung Disease. So in mild COPD, there will be 80% or more than that prediction of what? Of FEV1. Of FEV1. In moderate, there will be 79% to 50% or 50% to 79%. And in severe, 30% to 49%. And in very severe, less than 30%. Or less than 50% with respiratory failure or signs of heart failure. So this criteria is important. You don't have to write anything else, just mark about the symptoms, that is this plus signs, okay, mark that, write mild, moderate, severe and very severe, and write about this FEV1 greater than 80, FEV1 50% to 79%, FEV1 30% to 49%, and FEV1 less than 30% or less than 50% with respiratory failure or signs of heart failure. Okay, now coming to the treatment part. So the treatment for chronic bronchitis, here I've used the mnemonic ABCD VIM. Yeah guys, ABCD VIM. Okay, let's see what it stands for. So A for avoid bronchial irritants. That person is having difficulty to breathe, so avoid smoking, or if that person is a housewife or a person who is staying at home working with all the gas, then try to avoid the gas smoke and aerosol sprays, deodorant, stuff like that, or areas which is very polluted in the atmosphere. Second, B stands for bronchodilators. So you have to give oral theophylline 150 mg BID, or you have seen people using inhalers, so salbutamol or terbutaline. Salbutamol 200 mcg every 6 hours. Then C for corticosteroids. So prednisolone can be given 30 mg per day for 2 weeks, and domiciliary oxygen therapy in low concentration, that is 2 liter per minute. This you can do at house itself, but in advanced or severe condition of the disease, you have to go to the hospital. Now we have done A, B, C, D. Coming to the next part, that is VIM, V for vaccines. So usually the people who are having this bronchitis, they have high chances of getting what? Getting these two diseases, that is influenza and pneumococcal infection. So it is better if the patient is given vaccine for influenza and pneumococcal infections. Then infection you have to treat. There will be what, superlethal infections will be there, so that you have to treat with antibiotics, and you have to give mucolytic agents like bromhexin and carboxystin. To know more about pharmacological drugs, to remember all these dosage, we will be doing a separate video. Okay, try to remember at least the treatment regimen with the mnemonic ABCDVIM. Okay, now coming to the treatment for emphysema, medically there is no specific treatment because it is irreversible. So usually what we do is we give treatment for the associated bronchitis. And in conditions if there is core pulmonale, I'll tell you what it is. It is a complication. So core pulmonale means right side heart failure or right ventricular hypertrophy due to some lung disease. Okay, that is what core pulmonale means. So if the person is having core pulmonale, then he or she should be hospitalized and given oxygen therapy intermittently with salt restrictions. But there are other conditions. If that person is having heart failure, you can give ACE inhibitors, or if the patient is showing symptoms of arrhythmia, you can give digoxin. So that depends on the conditions. Now surgically, what you can do is bullectomy, lung volume reduction surgery, and reduction pneumoplasty when there is advanced diffuse emphysema. Okay, now coming to the complications of chronic bronchitis, there will be secondary infections, core pulmonale, which I told you what it is, type 1 and type 2 respiratory failure. I tell you what type 1 and type 2, the difference, the important thing to know is in type 1, there will be low oxygen and normal to like little less carbon dioxide. But in type 2, evidently low oxygen and low carbon dioxide will be there. So then secondary polycythemia. In emphysema, there will be pneumothorax. What is pneumothorax? It is the rupture of bullae in the pleural space. Okay, that is called as pneumothorax. So there can be pneumothorax, core pulmonale, or type 2 respiratory failure. These are the complications. Now I'll tell you about the questions which have been asked. So we have discussed about the definition. You have to write COPD's definition, emphysema definition, and clinical relation along with chronic bronchitis definition and clinical relation. Clinical features, don't forget to write about the pink puffer and blue bloater and the age and dyspnea and cough and cyanosis and edema. These are important, and rest of it you can add about the investigation. If you remember the investigation, you can write the differences, signs and symptoms. Then in investigation, you have to write, start from the history and end with the individual features which is seen. Okay, start from the history and write about all those individual features. Management, write in detail for bronchitis, and in emphysema I told you how the management will be. It is always associated to what infection the person has other than this word emphysema. Okay, then complications, I told you all the complications. Complications is not asked very frequently, but after all, if you are writing it, it is always considered as an added point. You might score more marks. Okay, so reference, I have referred clinical textbook or textbook of clinical medicine, Dr. S. N. Chug and Dr. Anshul Chug. So go back and read. And if you have any doubts and if you want more clarity in explanation, or if you didn't understand some terms, or you have some topic as suggestion which you want to know more about, you can just follow us on Dental School in Instagram and DM us there, or else you can mail us directly to dentalschoolfor@gmail.com, or else you can directly comment in the comment section below. All right, so thank you.